Yo, Sad Boy and Heartbreak Hours continue, so let's just keep this thing rolling with more sad songs. Roll it. Now, obviously, if you've been on the channel in the last 2 to 3 weeks, you know that I'm sad to a level that I didn't even think was an imaginable level. And whenever I'm feeling sad, I listen to the saddest songs to try to bring me down to the lowest point possible. So that way you can only go up from here, you know? That's not true. You can stay down there, but it's a risk I'm willing to take. Listening to sad music when I'm sad is very cathartic for me. So I thought I might as well put y'all on to some said this what you come to me for is if you wanna know what's going on music-wise. So let me put you on to what's going on music-wise for me. This song right here is one of my favorite songs. Poetry wise, it's jarring, it's heartbreaking, and I didn't even know there was a music video for it, so this is new to me. But we got Jesse Reyez, Before Love Came to Kill Us. Let's get it. I love Jesse Reyez's video style with like the washed out blacks, like the black levels are risen so they're not so deep. It's like very faded. It makes it feel vintagey and it makes it feel kind of surreal. Like if it was regular, you wouldn't feel like that.
Love you in the worst way. You knocked me down like a heavyweight. We fell in love, got a KO. Oh no, too damn young, so we broke up. No go. So much for a wedding date.
Yo, love you in the worst way, bro. Like, all right out the gate, that's poetic because it's like, I love you in the worst way because I wish that I didn't have this love for you. Because it's the love for you that's breaking my heart and there's no way that that's going away. I said forever and I meant it, you know? You knocked me down like a heavyweight. We fell in love, but it was a KO. Like, we got knocked out because we were so young. So much for a wedding date.
Too damn young, so we broke up. No go. So much for a wedding date. I know nobody gets out of love alive. We either break up when we're young or we say goodbye when we die. For a moment at least I know you were mine and it was beautiful. But winter comes and roses don't survive. It's getting late and I should go.
Bro, that was when I heard that for the first time. It was honestly the most hauntingly beautiful, poetic thing that I had ever heard in my life. I read, I study the American and British literature. I study poets. I study like true artistry of poetry. And people can get very in depth with like the things that they're saying and have it like all these different meanings out of like the best poets are able to do that. But there's something so beautifully simplistic and complex about what she's saying right here. Nobody gets out of love alive. We either break up when we're young, which means we didn't get out of it alive because the relationship is dead, or we say goodbye when we die. Bro, when I had heard that, like, same. For a moment, at least I know that you were mine and it was beautiful, but I should have known. I should have known because winter comes and roses don't survive. Bro, like the moment was beautiful. The time that we spent together was amazing. It was everything that I could have wished for. But eventually winter comes and reality sets in and roses and love don't survive. Psh, bro.
For a moment at least I know you were mine and it was beautiful. But winter comes and roses don't survive. It's getting late and I should go.
Before love came to kill us, I want to hold you like it's June in the West End. Like just this memory that she has. Like I wish I could go back to that memory. I wish we could go back in time and just stay permanently there. Like it's June and back when you were my best friend before love came to kill us. Like why couldn't we just have been best friends? Why did we let that love and that relationship grow and flourish knowing that it was coming to kill us? Now not only did I lose the love of my life, but I lost my best friend in the process because they're one and the same person. That love killed two birds with one stone. Psh, bro, shit is just so good. It's so sad, bro. And on top of that, she's like on top of the car singing in slow motion because That's the way time feels. It feels like time can't move fast enough when you're heartbroken. And it feels like time moves too fast whenever you're in love. You want time to move slower so you can cherish those memories, but you want time to move fast so that way you don't have time to feel the heart, to feel your broken heart, you know? And everything is in slow motion on this part of the video. It's perfect.
Ooh, I'm my best friend. Before love.
We're not supposed to. We're not supposed to meet. We're not supposed to talk. We broke up. There should be no communication. But I can't help myself. I can't learn my lesson to just cut ties completely because I miss when you were my best friend. I miss those times. So I don't care if I can't learn my lesson. I don't care if we're not supposed to talk. If we talk, then it's because I want. It's what I want. Even if it's wrong, it's what feels right. You know.
Before love.
Under the mask of the moon, like under the moonlight, can we dance in the past? Like, can we just have that one, like as they're dancing in the pool water? It's obviously a metaphor. Could we dance in the past before love came to kill us? Can we just go back to those times at least one last time under the moonlight? Bro, like I said, the poetry, the writing capability of Jessie Reyez, like poetry wise, without the music in the background, without her very unique voice that adds pain and it adds anger and like resentment for the situation, I guess. Like without all that, if you just read the lyrics, this song would be one of the most beautiful poems that you've ever read. No one gets out of love alive. We either break up when we're young or we say goodbye when we die. For a moment, at least I know that you were mine and it was beautiful. But winter comes and roses don't survive. But I want to hold you like it's June in the West End, back when you were my best friend, before love came to kill us. It's fucking crazy, bro. And I fuck with her whole aesthetic too. I think that's what makes it even like takes it to the next level.
Life's good and I'm happy, but I think about today. When I miss you, I medicate. Drink. Tears come out like a renegade.
Bro, just like. The two different sections of the song, it's like very light, like what she's saying, like, oh, I'm trying to get over you. I'm trying to move past it. I'm trying to brush you off. And it's like comical to her that she can't. And after she laughs, like, cause that's all that you can really do is I gotta laugh. I can't let this person go no matter how much I want to. And then it like completely goes in the opposite direction whenever the actual pre-hook and hook comes. It's crazy. And it's just like, this is the future. This is the reality. This is gonna be the reality of my future, basically. Life's good and I'm getting paid. Like I'm making YouTube videos. I'm a YouTuber. Like it's a dream job for a lot of people. But I still, even if my life is going good, it's not as good as it could be because I still think about you every day. When I miss you, I medicate. I just get drunk, bro. Just that feeling of like that person that you are never going to get that person back, but you also can't erase them from your memory. This is an eternal sunshine of the spotless mind, no matter how bad I might want it to be.
Tears come out like a renegade. Cause nobody gets out of love alive. We either break up when we're young or we say goodbye when we die. For a moment at least I know you were mine and it was beautiful. Winter comes and roses don't.
Bro, the pre-chorus, which I'm assuming that is, it sticks in my mind every single day because it's like a thought and a concept. It's like a very dark idea of what love is, you know? Like, normally when you think love, you think, you know, roses, you think everybody, this is such a happy feeling, feeling content, feeling secure. But just this feeling of love is the way that it feels now. And I had never even thought of it as such a dark concept before. Nobody gets out of love alive. Like, everybody wants to be in love. Everybody feels like it's a good thing. But in the reality, but winter inevitably comes, and roses, no matter how beautiful they are, winter comes and roses don't survive, bro. You see how, like, it's, you see how she's like on top of the car moving in slow motion, talking about like the memories, because time can't move fast enough. And I'm sure that they were driving at normal speed because she's moving in slow motion, but her lips are lip synced perfectly. So I'm assuming they took the track and like split and sped it up by like double, so that way she could like sing and move in fast motion, but then they slow it down in post to be like normal speed, the song to be normal speed. And it looks like she's singing in slow motion. It's such a good visual interpretation of what it feels like, how time moves whenever you're heartbroken. It's dope. Before love came to kill us, we're not supposed to. But I can't learn my lesson. See how she like smiles right there? Because it's like, it's comical at this point. Like, I know we're not supposed to, but I can't learn my lesson no matter how bad I should. I miss when you. The shit is just before love came to kill us. Shit is sad, bro. God damn. And her voice is so fragile and so filled with emotion, especially when she goes up there and she sings through her nose. Like, yo, just another song. I'm taking y'all on this cathartic release journey that I'm going on. These are songs that are on my playlist for heartbreak. Jesse, if you're watching this, this is one of the best songs that I have ever heard written. At least in terms of like songwriting capabilities, just everything that goes into this song, the poetic nature of how painful love is. No one talks about it. They talk about how painful the breakup is. They don't talk about how painful the love is, bro. That's all I gotta say. But yo, that brings us to the end of this video, ladies and gentlemen. If you like what you see, please consider liking the video, leaving a comment down below. If you like what you see enough, please consider subscribing. You want to support the channel monetarily, maybe you want to help like have a bigger hand than just subscribing, consider joining the Patreon. If you want to support the Twitch monetarily, that'd be great as well. That both of those links are the first ones in the description. I don't care about anything right now in terms of social medias. Do what you got to do, but I always say it brings us to the very end of our video. Go out there in the world, love and care for one another, love and care for each other. And I'll catch everybody in the next video. Peace.